Humanity generates so much trash that we don't even have a system in place to deal with all of it. Some unethical solutions have popped up, like shipping trash to other countries, dumping trash in the ocean, or creating massive dumping grounds that are then buried so tightly that the trash lacks the environmental forces needed to break down. What if I told you there was a stupidly easy solution to all of this that we have overlooked since 1977? Guys, gals, and non-binary pals, I present the ultimate garbage-eating machine! The Otyugh! Welcome back to Compendium of Monsters, it's Otyugh Week. Before we continue, slap that subscribe button and hail the solution to a cleaner planet. Just kidding, they're not real. Otyughs are challenge level 5, and even though you can fight them, you probably shouldn't. These large aberrations have an armor class of 14, average hit points of 114, a speed of 30 feet, and dark vision out to 120 feet. In keeping with Wizards' bizarre language creations, Otyughs speak Otyugh. What does Otyugh sound like? Your guess is as good as mine. Probably grunts and roars. Otyughs have the limited telepathy ability, which allows them to communicate telepathically with a creature within 120 feet. The target creature must speak at least one language, and this form of telepathy is limited to simple messages or images. Limited telepathy does not allow the receiving creature to telepathically respond. Are you getting weird messages that only you can hear? It could be an Otyugh. Otyughs have a triple multi-attack that allows them to make one bite attack and two tentacle attacks. An Otyugh's bite attack deals an average of 12 piercing damage and forces a constitution saving throw against disease. I'm feeling flashbacks to the Rudderkin entry. On a success, there is no immunity. On a failure, the target creature is poisoned and can repeat the saving throw once every 24 hours. Each time the creature fails after the first, their maximum number of hit points is reduced by an average of 5. If a creature's maximum hit points reach 0 due to this effect, they immediately die. Also, the reduction to their hit points lasts until the disease is cured. Luckily for basically every adventuring party at level 5, you're all but guaranteed to have someone with lesser restoration or a similar effect. One charge of a Paladin's Lay on Hands can cure disease, and it's significantly more efficient than a second level spell slot. The tentacle attack is split into two different possibilities. Tentacle, by itself I suppose, and Tentacle Slam. On a successful hit, the tentacle attack deals an average of 11 damage split between bludgeoning and piercing damage, but also automatically grapples a creature. The creature is restrained until the grapple ends, and the Otyugh can grapple up to two creatures. Remember, a restrained creature has a movement speed of 0 feet, is attacked with advantage to hit, and attacks with disadvantage to hit. With one or more grappled creatures, an Otyugh can use its Tentacle Slam action in place of a tentacle attack. Tentacle Slam deals an average of 10 bludgeoning damage and forces a constitution saving throw against a stun that lasts until the end of the Otyugh's next turn. On a success, the creature takes half damage and is not stunned. Since I believe in giving credit where credit is due, whoever designed this tentacle slam attack gave it the right amount of damage and also left the door open for wily dungeon masters to inflict a little extra damage against their players' characters. If an Otyugh slams two creatures into each other, the creatures inflict an additional average of 7 bludgeoning damage to one another from the force of their collision. Or a DM could force a nearby ungrappled martial melee class to make a dexterity saving throw as the Otyugh tries to slam their friend into them. This puts additional emphasis on slipping the Otyugh's grapple, because while an additional 14 damage per round isn't necessarily ridiculous, it's going to quickly expend the healer's available resources. If regular Otyughs aren't your thing, don't worry! There are several flavors of Otyugh. Just don't taste them, because you are what you eat.
In garbage!
You could use Neo Otyughs from the Infernal Machine Rebuild PDF. They are significantly stronger than regular Otyughs and have a challenge level to match this increase in power. If you'd like to go easy on your player's characters, you could use a Reduced Threat Otyugh. While the damage it deals remains unchanged, Reduced Threat Otyughs do not have a Tentacle Slam action, have half the health of a regular Otyugh, and have two-thirds the chance to hit their target. Any creature with a reduced threat stat block is one your player's characters will treat like a doormat. If you're lucky. Or let's say your players are being extremely rude and you need a creature to put them in their place. How about the Hangry Otyugh from Adventure with Muck? Similarly to how you behave when you're hangry, Hangry Otyugh speaks no languages. Not even Otyugh, which is a bit of a surprise. A Hangry Otyugh deals a decent amount of damage for its bite attack, but for some reason has an insane twist for its tentacle attack. On a hit, it forces a DC 19 constitution saving throw against an average of 42 poison damage. It's a challenge level 5 creature that has the potential to deal 147 damage per round. For context, 147 damage per round is expected of a challenge level 21 creature, not a challenge level 5. Surely this must be a typo.
Don't call me Shirley.
As their creature type indicates, Otyughs were created by magic gone wrong. Was it a magic user or a cosmic clusterfuck that created them? Presumably a magic user, but I'll get more into that in a moment. In case it wasn't obvious what Otyughs add to the multiverse, they consume ridiculous amounts of garbage, waste, and carrion. Otyughs typically bury their 8-foot diameter bodies under mountains of cast-off material and only keep their sensory eye stalk exposed. This really is a two-fer strategy. Primarily, the Otyugh can just shovel food straight into its mouth, but it can also keep an eye out for unsuspecting creatures. Yes, despite being a large, stinky aberration, Otyughs enjoy fresh meat every so often. I imagine fresh meat is difficult to come by unless they're very sneaky. If you're looking to find an Otyughs, the likelihood you'll find one above ground is slim. Otyughs above ground are typically found in swamps, damp forests, animal pens, or even graveyards. Otherwise, the Underdark is your best bet to not only find, but potentially tame an Otyughs. Yes, you can tame an Otyughs if you offer it a metric ton of waste to consume and wallow in. This is the main reason why I assume a magic user created Otyughs. Otherwise, an Otyughs is a wild aberration that should attack humans on sight regardless of food offered. So long as you continue to provide adequate amounts of refuse, the Otyughs will remain in your service. However, wild animals typically remain wild despite human efforts to domesticate them. If an Otyughs is not adequately supplied with food, it will wander from its feeding area, and there is apparently a very high likelihood that the Otyughs will consume the creature initially providing it with food. This reminds me of a story my partner told me. A man named Timothy Treadwell once deluded himself into thinking he was a grizzly bear whisperer. Long story short, after winning a lengthy battle with severe alcoholism and drug addiction, Timothy suddenly found an affinity for grizzly bears. He spent a long time in Alaska where he would regularly interact with bears despite the protests and concerns from park rangers and conservationists. It is hypothesized that Timothy was not killed by any of the grizzlies he regularly interacted with because, among other things, from the bear's perspective, he behaved so erratically that they were confused.
Like, dude, I'm several thousand pounds heavier than you. I'm a dangerous bear. Why are you not as scared?
Despite consistent safety warnings, he refused to put up electric fencing around his campsite and did not carry bear mace or even pepper spray. Predictably, he was killed in late September 2003 by a bear he was unfamiliar with who was preparing for hibernation. Unfortunately, he dragged his girlfriend into this fatal final event and she died while unsuccessfully attempting to save him from the grizzly's attack. Perhaps we should leave the wild animals alone, eh? They're called wild for a reason. I am very fond of Otyughs because they're whimsical, strange creatures that have an incredibly important role to play in local ecosystems. Anytime the amount of rot exceeds nature's ability to break it down, Otyughs can step in and restore the balance. Sure, Otyughs eat living things, but not in the same quantities as they eat things already decaying. With their intelligence score of 6, Otyughs aren't smart enough to be supreme evil beings. They just follow the source of food wherever it may take them. If you do end up in combat with an Otyughs, its level of hunger should communicate how willing it is to kill you. If an Otyughs is merely hungry, it's likely to flee combat after losing more than half of its hit points, or it might be assuaged if given copious amounts of food. If you have a spellcaster who can cast Create Food and Water, that might buy you enough time to bypass the Otyughs while it snarfs down whatever was conjured up. If an Otyughs is starving, the likelihood that it will allow any potential meals to escape is near zero. A starving Otyughs is more likely to fight until it dies, especially if there are no significant food sources within a large radius. As far as what inspired Otyughs, my quest to discover their history was not particularly fruitful. The closest thing I could find was the trash compactor creature from Star Wars Episode 1, A New Hope. It is called a Dianoga and seems vaguely similar enough that it is plausible Gary Gygax could have used it. A New Hope was released in May 1977, and the first edition of the Monster Manual debuted in September 1977. I'm not saying it might have been an influence, but I'm not saying it either. Anyways, what do you think of Otyughs? Have you had any Otyughs appear in your campaign? Let me know in the comments below. A special thank you to my incredible patrons. And thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that subscribe button, smash that like button, share my video on your Twitter, Facebook, or other social media, and make the leap to become one of my patrons on Patreon. I'll see you next time.